For the sauce veracruz, you're going to need some olive oil, julienne onion, julienne green bell pepper, garlic, oregano, crushed tomatoes with the juice, and kosher salt and pepper to taste. Okay, for the onion, just make sure you take off the core at the other end and just slice. Do the same thing with the bell peppers. You don't need to take off the ribs. This is more of a rustic dish. So just cut just like that. Make sure they're all cut through. Then you're going to crush the garlic. Doesn't have to be completely minced. And there you go. Okay, in a little pot, get some olive oil, about a tablespoon. Add your bell peppers and your onions. And you want to sweat those out first. So break them down. Like that. Lower your flame. You don't want to burn them. So lower your flame a little. And again, all you're doing is sweating these out. Then add your garlic. Then add your tomato sauce. You might have to adjust with a little water, but you want to let this simmer for at least 10 to 15 minutes. And then you can play around with all kinds of other spices. If you want to add chilies to it, if you want a little more hot spice, you can add some chili. Chili flakes, jalapenos, green chilies, whatever you like. Then finally we'll add the oregano and we'll let that simmer for at least 15 minutes. 10 to 15 minutes. Then at the end, you'll adjust with salt and pepper. For the Spanish rice, I have vegetable oil, an onion, long grain rice, we have garlic we're gonna chop, we have in a container, we have 3/4 cups of chicken broth with a 1/4 cup tomato sauce, and a pinch of cumin, and then we're going to use salt and pepper to taste. Okay, so you're going to be breading the chicken. So I have some flour, seasoned flour, flour with black pepper and salt. So you'll have it seasoned. This is the standard breading procedure, so there's the process in which to do this, and once you learn it, you can do any kind of breading. Fish and chips, you can do mushrooms, zucchini, fish, anything like that. So you have your seasoned flour, you have your egg wash, which consists of eggs and milk, and then you have your breadcrumbs. Okay, you can do all kinds of other breadings. If I wanted to make this like a Dorito, I can add some crushed Doritos to this and do the same thing. So what you'll do is you're gonna grab your chicken, place it into the seasoned flour. Now you're gonna have one hand wet, one hand dry. So this is gonna be my dry hand. So I'm gonna pat out the excess, very important. Get rid of the excess flour. Shake it off a little. Okay. This is my wet, or this is my wet right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to place this in here. Then I'm going to grab a little of the breadcrumb and place it in and place this on top. Okay. So you try to avoid getting any breadcrumbs onto your right hand or your left hand. Otherwise you're going to bread your fingers. And this will make it stick all the way through. If you Don't shake off the excess. You're going to have little pockets of white flour showing. Okay, then you'll place this in your... Okay, so again, here's our dry. With the dry hand, remember this is my wet. This is my wet hand. Okay, submerge it completely and then shake off the excess flour. So just give it a light shake. Okay, into the egg wash. Here's my wet. This is my dry. Okay, place that in. Try to place it in as even as possible or flat. Okay. Grab a little, place it in, place it on top, and then I usually let my hand drip right into the okay. Make sure you get all of it. Now, if I was doing like a chicken parm, then I would actually have Parmesan cheese in this breading. Okay, there you go. Okay, dry hand, wet hand, dry. I'm going to show you what will happen if you were to use your wet hand on a dry. I'll show you exactly when we're done. So shake off the excess. Very important. Okay. Into the batter. Here's your wet. Turn it around. And grab a little from the top. Make sure some make contact with the bottom. Set it down gently. And there you go. Set it in. Now, if let's just say, for instance, I went into the wet with the dry. So what'll happen is if I stick my hand into the breadcrumbs using a wet, basically what I'm doing is I'm breading my fingers, okay? And then it gets really messy. So that's why you want to use the wet, one hand for the dry, one hand for the wet. Okay, this is what your rice looks like when it comes out. Okay, it should have some, and then you just want to fluff it with the fork. Just like that, okay? And this is what your sauce Veracruz will look like. This will be placed on top of the chicken, and then you're going to place it into the oven with some cheddar cheese. Okay, so you're going to get some oil. You guys are actually going to deep fry this. Okay, so we're going to do a shallow fry. So you'll place one in, just like that. And all you really want to do is brown it, and then we'll get it into our pans, and then you're going to go into the oven just to make sure it's completely cooked. If it's completely cooked, not a big deal, because you still got to melt your cheese anyway. So this, if you pound it, it shouldn't take but maybe 3 minutes to fry, and then maybe just enough to melt the cheese. So you got a nice little brown. And I would say we want it darker on that side, so we'll let this go a little longer. Also, don't forget, you don't want to go completely golden brown, because again, you're going to go into the oven. So that's going to kind of brown it up a little bit too, at least along the edges. Now, if you don't pound it, then you will have to make sure you go in a little longer. So this is ready. Let it drain. Then with the second one. Let that drain a little bit. Set it on your pan. I've got a pan here, ready to go. You can even throw a little oil on the top just to get it browned a little bit. Okay, we got that nice, good, beautiful brown color that we're looking for. Just a nice little brown. Make sure you get the other side. Let it drain. Place it in your pan. And that should do it. Let that drain. Okay, the next step is to place your Veracruz sauce on top. Just like that. Be generous with it. Make sure you get some of the sauce. Then you're going to place some cheese. On top. You may add the black olives if you'd like, or you can just wait until after. I'm going to go ahead and place some on top now. Like this. Just like that. And if you want to add a little more cheese, you can add a little more cheese to it. Then you're going to place it in the oven just to melt it. Roughly 5 minutes. Okay, for the plate up, you'll get your chicken breast after it's removed from the oven. Okay, you've got your cheese nice and melted. You'll get your rice, place it on. Make sure you stay within the rim. Then you're going to garnish. Hit it with some sour cream. You can also go avocado, a nice avocado fan, or you can go with guacamole. Hit it with some sour cream. Keep it on there. And then you can finish it off with some green onion. And you have your chicken Mexicali. And there you go.